Hey, good morning, everybody. Welcome to Wake Up to the Word. I got my Kansas City hat on today because my sister, Lori, it was her birthday last week, and she's a Kansas City fan. She lives over there in Overland Park. And so, big shout out to Lori. Happy birthday, Lori.
Yes.
And of course, we representing the Chiefs for her. I'm a Steelers fan, but today I am giving you the Chiefs hat. But anyway, we are in Philippians chapter 1 today, and we hope you guys are doing well. Here's the verse of the day: being confident of this very thing, Paul writes, okay, as he's talking to this church at Philippi, as he's telling them how he's thankful for them and praying for them. He's saying, being confident of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. You know, God is always going to be working in us and finishing what he started in us. I have a lot of projects, Gabby will tell you, that I haven't finished. I need to keep finishing. Maybe this coronavirus time where you're isolating your house, you're able to finish some of the projects you haven't completed yet. But it's an opportunity for you to maybe take some time and go, oh man, I'm going to clean that, or I'm going to fix that, or I'm going to take care of that, reorganize the closet, whatever it may be. You know, it gives you a little extra time while you're sort of locked in. In the same way, I think that although we don't finish things, God always finishes things. He is the finisher, you know. Jesus, for the joy set before him, went to the cross and endured the cross and finished the work that he was going to do for you and me. And so we get this opportunity where we know that God is working on us. And what is he doing in us through this whole coronavirus thing and everything, the isolation, all the problems that are going down? How is he working in us? I think he's really working in us. He's challenging us, pray every day, challenging how you relate to your family or relate to others, even through work or through texting or FaceTime, whatever it may be. But God's doing a work, man. He's finishing a work. And I think through all of this, he's still completing the work in us. It's not like he stopped because coronavirus has forced us. He's still working if you let him work. And so what we got to do is we got to continue to let him work in us, and we can be confident that he who has begun a good work, when you became a Christian, when you started to follow Jesus Christ as your Savior, man, that is when that change in you began to happen, right? When you're in Christ, you're a new creation. Old things pass away, all things become new. And there's still things that he's working on. There's still things that he's changing, that he's building, that he's growing you in. And man, when we get into a trial or a problem like this, that I believe is when God, that pressure of that begins to change us even more, if we allow him to change us. So I think this is a great time for us to ask God, what do you want to change in me during this? What are the things that maybe I've lost focus of, or maybe my faith has lacked in, or what do you want to do to help me be complete until you come back for us, Lord? Until that day, maybe we're raptured out of here. What is it, Lord, that you want to change in me? Because I know you want to finish the work in me. So I think just like you may have projects around the house or stuff that you haven't finished, maybe this is the time where you begin to work on. Remember, as you begin to work on those, that God is working on you. He's finishing you. He's finishing the work. And no matter how tough this is, no matter how difficult this season is, God is still working. So I know that we've had friends recently that have told us, man, we have a friend and a family member that's sick. We've got somebody that got coronavirus over here. We have a friend who lost a loved one through coronavirus. So I want to pray for all those people because, man, there's a lot of comfort. And even in the midst of that, you know, we could ask, well, God, what are you doing? Why would you allow it? And we don't always know the answers to that, but we know that God is still with us and he's still working in us. So I thought we would just take a moment to pray and ask God to just comfort those and strengthen those and heal our land. So let's pray together, shall we? God, we thank you so much for the fact that you care about us, that you are finishing the work in us no matter what is going on in our lives. And Lord God, I just pray that you would comfort those that have lost loved ones, that have loved ones that are sick right now, that you would give them hope and strength. We pray for miracles for those that need miracles right now. Lord God, please may you pour out your hand of grace and mercy and touch those and heal those. And thank you, Jesus, that you are able, that you're the same today as you were yesterday and forever. And we just pray for a miracle for those that need healing. God, we pray for strength for those that are going through this time. We pray for comfort for those that have lost loved ones. And Lord, perseverance for all of us, Lord, as we go forward. And God, we thank you that you are with us. You're never going to leave us or forsake us. And so, God, be with us this day and continue to do the work in us. No matter what hits us, Lord, we're going to trust you. No matter what comes our way, help us to trust you and that you are going to work in and through us. We thank you and we ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Well, we're so glad that you're able to hang out with us. Sorry we didn't have a view for you today. You know, it was a backyard summit today. So maybe tomorrow we'll be back out with a view. But hey, once again, keep persevering and know that God is with you in the midst of all this. And may the Lord bless you and have an awesome day. Bye.